إِنَّا خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ مِنْ نُطْفَةٍ أَمْشَاجٍ نَبْتَلِيهِ فَجَعَلْنَاهُ سَمِيعًا بَصِيرًا.
That is the second stage of life. Life in your mother's stomach or tummy, life at the womb. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned it in Surah Al-Furqan regarding what your creation, the way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created you. So, and life at this stage, you can live it between 1 second and 9 to 10 months. In Lawhul Mahfuz, there is no time limit. Only Allah knows the time you come to the existence. In your mother's belly, you stay for 1 second or 9 months. Between 1 second and 9 months. That is the period. Then the next stage of life is life in this dunya, if you come to this dunya. And that is between 1 second and 60 to 70 years. That is the average. Because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "A'maru ummati," the lifespan of my ummah is between 60 and 70. Only few will be among the lucky ones that will go above that. So that is the second stage, the third stage of life. And the fourth is life in the grave. Al-haya fil qabr. And that's the period only Allah knows. It depends on the time you come to this world. Like Prophet Adam alayhi salam, from the day he died until the day Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will resurrect all of us for judgment, Prophet Adam will remain in his grave. So if you are within the period of Adam alayhi salam, you remain in the grave until Qiyamah. If you are in this ummah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you remain in your grave to the day that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will gather all of us for Qiyamah. So that is the next stage of life, life in the grave. And the next stage is life on the day of Qiyamah. In that stage, you are going to live or stay for 50,000 years standing. You will stand for 50,000 years. That is Qiyamah. Then after Qiyamah, then lie at the final stage, which is Darul Na'im or the other house. Jannah or Nar. And life at that stage is Abadan. Abadan means forever. No time limit to it. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for us. So today we are going to discuss life at the fifth stage, which is Qiyamah. But before we start, Allah has summarized all these stages in Surah Al-Abasa. If we go to Surah Al-Abasa, Allah says, "Utila al-insanu ma akfara." Utila al-insanu ma akfara. Min ayyi shay'in khalaqa. Min nutfatin khalaqahu faqaddara. Thumma as-sabila yassara. ثم أماته فأقبره ثم إذا شاء أنشره كلا 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 لما يقض ما أمره كلا لما يقض ما cause is man. Ma akfara. What is it? that makes him to be ungrateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You think you are someone, Allah tells you about yourself that you are not more than this. Your story is the shortest. Listen to your story. Listen to our stories. Our story is between these stages. What is the first stage? Min ayyi shay'in khalaqa. Min ayyi shay'in khalaqa. From what Allah created him? Min nutfati khalaqahu faqaddara. From a drop of water, Allah created him, and then Allah proportioned him. Allah made his adab, his risk, and everything at that stage. Remember the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam: everyone is created in the tummy of his mother. The angel will write his adab, his risk, either shaqi or sa'id. Is for Jannah or is for Nar, subhanAllah. So, Allah says, after that, you now come to the existence. You come to this world. Then your life at that stage, Allah describes it in one ayah by saying, ثُمَّ السَّبِيلَ يَسَّرَ. Then Allah made the way easy for him to choose between two options. Either to choose right or wrong. Inna hadaynahu sabila imma shakiran wa imma kafura. That is your life in this dunya. And you are going to live that life for 1 second to 60 years or 70. That is the average. If you are very lucky, maybe you go up to 100. No one can pass 200 in this ummah. And if we can find one or two, that person is the luckiest. So the maximum you can live is 200 years. But remember, the Akhirah, the day of judgment, you are going to stand for 50,000 years. And in Ma'ad, the final stage, you are going to stay there forever. Now the question you ask yourself is, are you willing to sacrifice this 60 years, 70 years for that 50 years? Do you think you should enjoy yourself for 60 years, 70 years, or 200 years and suffer for 50,000 years? Does that make sense? If you don't want that, now we can go proper into our topic, which is the day of standing, Yawm al-Qiyamah. What is this day? Why is it called Yawm al-Qiyamah? Allah called it with many names in the Quran. If you read the Quran, you see the name. Sometimes Allah will call it Yawm al-Qiyamah. Yawm al-Qiyamah. Like he said in Surah al-Qiyamah, La uqsimu biyawmil qiyamah. What is qiyamah? Qiyamah means the day of standing. Sometimes Allah will call it al-azifa, meaning the one that draws very near, the one that comes very close. Like he said in Surah Al-Najm, azifatil azifa. Qiyamah has come. Qiyamah is very close. Don't think that Qiyamah is far. It's not far. We may think it's far, but it's very close. Because Allah said in the Quran, إِنَّهُمْ يَرَوْنَهُ بَعِيدًا وَنَرَاهُ قَرِيبًا. They think that Qiyamah is far, but we see it as very close. It's very close. Remember when Allah was talking to Prophet Musa alayhi salam in Surah Taha, after giving him the instruction on Salah, the next thing Allah told him is, Inna sa'ata la'atiyatun akadu ukhfiha. Akadu ukhfiha litujiza kullu nafsim bima tas'a.
Inna sa'ata la'atiyah. Kiyama is coming. Akadu ukhfiha. I almost conceal it. Allah conceal the time of Qiyamah. Allah hide it. Allah make it hidden. It's not known to anyone. Why? Litujiza kullu nafsim bima tas'a. So that Allah will reward each soul according to what he or she does. That is the reason why Allah hide Qiyamah. Remember, Allah is not talking to Prophet Muhammad. He's talking to who? Prophet Musa. Since that time, Allah said, Inna sa'ata la'atiyah akadu ukhfiha litujiza kullu nafsim bima tas'a. But Allah told him, فَلَا يَصُدَّنَّكَ عَنْهَا مَنْ لَا يُؤْمِنُ بِهَا وَاتَّبَعَ هَوَاهُ فَتَرُدَى. Don't allow him, he who does not believe in Qiyamah, to prevent you, to stop you from doing what will save you or give you salvation on that day. If you allow him to distract you from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, on that day, you will be among those that will perish. Subhanallah. May Allah protect us. Al-Qiyamah. Sometimes Allah will call it Al-Haqqa. Al-Haqqa. What is Al-Haqqa? Qiyamah, the truth. You can't deny it. You can't stop it from happening. In other place, Allah will say, إِذَا وَقَعَتِ الْوَاقِعَةِ لَيْسَ لِوَقَعَتِهَا كَاذِبَةِ خَافِضَةُ الرَّافِعَةِ إِذَا رُجَّتِ الْأَرْضُ رَجَّةِ وَبُسَّتِ الْجِبَالُ بَسَّةِ فَكَانَتْ هَبَاءً مُنْبَسَّةِ. Sometimes Allah will call it Yawmul Jam. Yawma yajma'ukum li yawmil jam. Yawmul Jam means the day of gathering. Dhalika yawmut taghabun. That is the day of mutual benefit and loss. May Allah make it easy for us. We are not going to talk about the signs of Qiyamah because we already know them. The minor signs are many. There are more than 50. The major ones are 10. If you read or you listen to scholars, you know about the signs of Qiyamah. But let's start discussing Qiyamah as it's happening. What will happen? What will happen before Qiyamah? The first thing that will happen is there will be 3 blasts before Qiyamah. The first blast is people will be terrified. Go to Surah An-Naml. Do we know Surah An-Naml? Verse 87, Allah said, وَيَوْمَ يُنْفَخُ فِي الصُّورِ فَفَزِعَ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ إِلَّا مَنْ شَاءَ اللَّهِ وَكُلٌّ أَتَوْهُ دَاخِرِينَ وَيَوْمَ يُنْفَخُ فِي الصُّورِ. The day that the trumpet will be blown by angel Israfil alayhi salam. Israfil is the angel responsible for blowing the trumpet. Since the day Allah created him, he's holding the trumpet tightly. He does not even, you know, twinkle his eyes so that he will not miss any command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's ever ready to blow it. Then Allah said, the day that the trumpet shall be blown. Everything in the heavens and everything in the earth will be terrified. The only one that will not be terrified is except those whom Allah will. Who are they? Only Allah knows. Allah keeps it to himself. We don't know the people that will not be terrified with that blast. That is the first. What is the second blast? In same surah, go to Surah Zumar. Sorry, Surah Zumar. Surah Zumar. Surah number 39, verse 68. Allah said, وَنُفِخَ فِي الصُّورِ فَصَعِقَ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ إِلَّا مَنْ شَاءَ اللَّهِ. Between the first and the second, the prophet said there is 40 between them. Abu Huraira narrated that what is between the first blow and the second one is 40. Then the Tabi'un asked Abu Huraira, say, do you mean 40 days? He said, I will not tell you. 40 months? He said, I will not explain. 40 years? He said, I will not explain. According to scholars, they said, Abu Huraira could not explain because he does not have any knowledge regarding that. The Prophet mentioned, مَا بَيْنَ نَفْخَتَيْنِ أَرْبَعُونَ. What is between the first and the second is 40. Without giving the detail. So only Allah knows what will happen. And the first blast will happen on the criminals. You know, the people who are disobedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because the Prophet says they will be the only ones that will remain on the face of earth before Qiyamah. All the good people will die and leave the evil ones. So, that is the second blast. And at that, everything will perish. Everything will perish. If you go to Surah Al-Rahman, verse 26, Allah said, Kullu man alayha fan. You know that. Go to Surah Al-Qasas, the last verse. Allah said, Kullu shay'in halikun illa wajha. Surah Al-Qasas. So everything will perish at the second blast. Which one is the third? Still in Surah Zumar, the same verse. If you read the verse, continue your recitation, you hear where Allah says, ثُمَّ نُفِخَ فِيهِ أُخْرَى ثُمَّ نُفِخَ فِيهِ أُخْرَى فَإِذَا هُمْ قِيَامٌ يَنْظُرُونَ. Then there will be another blast. Behold, all of them will rise, looking on. La ilaha illallah. At that point, you will not realize that you're in the Qiyamah until Allah send the angels to come and drive people, to come and send them, come and lead them to the hall of Qiyamah. Because Allah said in Surah Zalzala, إِذَا زُلْزِلَتِ الْأَرْضُ زِلْزَالَهَا وَأَخْرَجَتِ الْأَرْضُ أَثْقَالَهَا وَقَالَ الْإِنسَانُ مَا لَهَا يَوْمَئِذٍ تُحَدِّثُ أَخْبَارَهَا بِأَنَّ رَبَّكَ أَوْحَى لَهَا يَوْمَئِذٍ يَصْدُرُ النَّاسُ أشتاتا ليروا أعمالهم فمن يعمل مثقال ذرة خيرا يره ومن يعمل مثقال ذرة شرا يره. Go and read Surah Al-Qiyamah. The Prophet said, whoever wants to see the scene of Qiyamah as though you are watching it live, read these three surahs. إِذَا السَّمَاءُ انشَقَّتْ Surah Al-Inshiqaq. إِذَا السَّمَاءُ انفَطَرَتْ Surah Al-Infitar. If you read these three surahs, you will see, you will have the clear vision of what is going to happen on the day of Qiyamah. May Allah make it easy for us. Now, Qiyamah will start. In that Surah Az-Zumar, Allah said, وَنُفِخَ فِي الصُّورِ فَصَعِقَ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ إِلَّا مَنْ شَاءَ اللَّهِ ثم نفخ فيه أخرى فإذا هم قيام ينظرون ونفخ في الصور فإذا هم من الأجداث إلى ربهم ينسلون قالوا يا ويلنا من بعثنا من مرقدنا هذا ما وعد الرحمن هذا ما وعد الرحمن وصدق المرسلون. Allah said, the trumpet will be blown. فَإِذَا هُمْ مِنَ الْأَجْدَاثِ إِلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ يَنْسِلُونَ They will come out. They will be resurrected. And they will move quickly to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They will all gather to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They will go to Allah for the judgment. You hear them saying, يَا وَيْلَنَا Woe unto us! مَنْ بَعَثَنَا مِنْ مَرْقَدِنَا قَالُوا يَا وَيْلَنَا مَنْ بَعَثَنَا مِنْ مَرْقَدِنَا Who resurrected us from our sleep? Then the angels will reply them, هَذَا مَا وَعَدَ الرَّحْمَنِ This is what the Most Merciful has promised you. وَصَدَقَ الْمُرْسَلُونَ And all the prophet spoke truth. What they said is true. It has come. Allah said, on that day, the horror and terror of that day is great. Because if you go to Surah Al-Hajj, Allah said, Ya ayyuhan nas, listen. Ya ayyuhan nas, not ya ayyuhal ladhina aman, not ya ayyuhal muslimun. La, mada? Ya ayyuhan nas, uttaqu rabbakum. O you people, fear your Lord. Be conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and be dutiful to Him. Inna zalzalata sa'ati shay'un azim. The earthquake of Qiyamah is something really, really terrible. يَوْمَ تَرَوْنَهَا The day, Qiyamah, You shall see Kiyama. The day you will see Kiyama, the day that Kiyama will happen, تَذْهَلُ كُلُّ مُرْضِعَةٍ عَمَّا أَرْضَعَتْ. You see a nursing mother who threw away her nursing baby.
وَتَضَعُ كُلُّ ذَاتِ حَمْلٍ حَمْلَهَا.
The pregnant woman, you know, drop her load.
وَتَرَى النَّاسَ سُكَارَى.
People will be confused as if they have taken intoxicants.
وَمَا هُمْ بِسُكَارَى وَلَكِنَّ عَذَابَ اللَّهِ شَدِيدٌ.
They are not drunken, but rather the punishment of Allah, that qiyama, that torment of Allah is a terrible thing, terrible thing. On that day, people in this dunya will ask the Prophet, they will say, oh, the Prophet of Allah, what will happen to the mountains on the day of qiyama? What will happen to this earth? What will happen to the heaven? Allah said in Surah Ibrahim,
يَوْمَ تُبَدَّلُ الْأَرْضُ غَيْرَ الْأَرْضِ وَالسَّمَاوَاتِ وَبَرَزُوا لِلَّهِ الْوَاحِدِ الْقَهَّارِ. يَوْمَ تُبَدَّلُ الأرض غير الأرض والسماوات.
The day that this earth will be changed with another earth, will be replaced with another earth, and so also the heaven, and everyone will be present, everyone will be made apparent before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one, the irresistible. The day that Allah will say in Surah Ghafir,
يَوْمَهُمْ بَارِزُونَ.
The day that they will all appear before Allah.
لِمَنِ الْمُلْكُ الْيَوْمِ.
Whose is the kingdom today? No one will reply Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. After a very long period of time, Allah will reply himself and said,
لِلَّهِ الْوَاحِدِ الْقَهَّارِ.
To Allah, Allah is the owner of kingdom today. Allah, the one, the irresistible, is the only one in charge of this day. You read that, I read that in Surah Al-Fatiha every Salah. You said,
مَالِكِ يَوْمِ الدِّينِ.
The master of the day of judgment. Yawm al-Qiyamah. Go to Surah Taha. From verse 107 to 111, Allah tells us what will happen to the mountains. Allah says,
يَوْمَئِذٍ يَتَّبِعُونَ الدَّبْرَ وَيَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ الْجِبَالِ فَقُلْ يَنْسِفُهَا رَبِّي نَسْفًا فَيَذَرُهَا قَاعًا صَفْصَفًا لَا تَرَى فِيهَا عِوَجًا وَلَا أَمْتًا. يَوْمَئِذٍ يَتَّبِعُونَ الدَّاعِيَ لَا عِوَجَ لَهُ وَخَشِعَتِ الْأَصْوَاتُ لِلرَّحْمَنِ فَلَا تَسْمَعُ إِلَّا هَمْسًا. يَوْمَئِذٍ لَا تَنْفَعُ الشَّفَاعَةُ إِلَّا مَنْ أَذِنَ لَهُ الرَّحْمَنُ ورضي له قولا. يعلم ما بين أيديهم وما خلفهم ولا يحيطون به علما.
The day that everyone will respond to the caller of Allah, that angel that is responsible to drive people, to chase people to that hall of Qiyamah, will all respond to him without deviating. And all voices will be silent before Allah. You will not hear anything except the sound of their feet. No one will talk. On that day, no intercession will benefit anyone. No one intercedes on that day except with the permission from Allah. No one speaks except with the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that day, Allah knows what will happen to you. Allah knows where you belong. Just like he knows what you did in this dunya.
يَعْلَمُ مَا بَيْنَ أَيْدِيهِمْ.
He knows what is before them.
وَمَا خَلْفَهُمْ.
And what is behind them.
وَلَا يُحِيطُونَ بِهِ عِلْمًا.
No one can encompass, can compass the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You can't comprehend the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is the day of Qiyamah. The horrific nature of Qiyamah. Do you know what will happen to this son? The prophet said, this son will be brought very, very close to people. The distance of which is not more than 1 mile. The narrator of the hadith says, I don't know, does he mean 1 mile of distance or that stick that is used to apply, you know, antimony powder to the eye, the coal to the eye? Does he mean that stick or the distance of a mile? I don't know. Whichever one, just imagine the son brought very close to you, 1 mile away from you. Remember, whenever it is sunny, the way you feel the scorching of the sun, the heat of the sun, it will be brought just 1 mile away. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, people will be submerged in their sweat according to their deeds. Some to the level of their ankles. Some to their knees. Some to their waist. And some will be completely submerged to their mouth and nose. Just imagine you are put in the water that reaches here, and you are not allowed to swim in that water. Imagine, just imagine that terrible moment. That is the day of Qiyamah. May Allah make it easy for us. Who stand, people, mankind, jinn, and all the creatures of Allah who stand for 40,000 years, Allah will not say anything. Allah will not even look at us. We will stand for 40,000 years. Allah will not say anything. We are waiting for judgment under that situation for 40,000 years. La ilaha illallah. Muhammadur Rasulullah. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allahumma sallim, Allahumma sallim. Then, after we've waited for 40,000 years, we'll be tired of waiting. We'll start discussing among ourselves and say, oh my God, what do we do now? We are really suffering please, who can beg Allah so that the judgment will begin? Who know our fate? Because standing, waiting for your fate, to know your fate, is another form of azab. Then people will go to Prophet Adam alayhi salam. Anyway, that topic is it will be handled by another speaker, the intercessors. But let's take the last part. They will go to Prophet Adam and say, please, you are the first man that Allah created. Can you beg Allah on our behalf so that judgment will be passed? Adam will say, Allah is so angry. Allah has never been so angry like this. And he will never be angry like this. I was instructed not to eat a fruit in Jannah, and I ate. I am afraid if I should go to Allah and Allah remembers that, I will be in trouble. I can't do that. Please go to Prophet Nuh alayhi salam. He's the first messenger. They will go to Ad, and then the Prophet Nuh will say the same thing. Give his excuse. He will send them to Prophet Ibrahim. Ibrahim alayhi salam will say the same thing. Prophet Musa will say the same thing. Prophet Isa will say, the only one that could talk to Allah today and Allah will listen is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Now, the question you ask yourself, are you among his nation? Do you obey him? Do you listen to his instructions? Do you follow his footsteps? If you don't do that, know that you will not be among his ummah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us be among the ummah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Prophet Muhammad will say, I am the one that will do that. I am not proud. Allah has given me. Then he will go and prostrate before Allah. Allah will leave him for a while. Then Allah will teach him the dua that he does not even know. That day, Allah will teach him what to say. He will glorify Allah and praise Allah with some words that he's not known to him. He will be taught that day. Then Allah will ask him, he say, oh Muhammad, what is the matter with you? What do you want? Ask whatever it is, I will give it to you. Do you know what the Prophet will ask? Say, Ya Rabbi, ummati, ummati, ummati. Allahu Akbar. That's why he said, Kullu ummati yadkhuluna al-jannata illa man aba. May Allah put us in his ummah. Then Allah will say, no problem, go, I will come for hisab. That is not the end. Remember, the day, the duration is for 50,000 years. We have waited for 40,000 years, now remaining 10 years. Hisab will be done within the period of 10,000 years. May Allah make it easy for us. Now, we are ready for hisab. What will happen before hisab? You think that scorching of the sun is the end? No. Some people will be under the shade of Allah. You know them. Seven people. The Prophet mentioned seven people that if you are one of them, you'll be under the shade of Arsh. May Allah put us among. Allah will come for hisab. After the intercession of who? Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now we are ready for hisab. But before Allah comes, everyone will be giving his book so that if it is time for hisab, if your name is called, you come with your book. Now we are ready to receive our books. If you are among the pious ones, you shall receive your book with your right hand. May Allah put us among those that will receive their books with right hand. If he or she, who is not here, inshallah, is among the Ashab al-Nar, he or she shall receive his or hers, her book behind her back. Subhanallah. May Allah make it easy for us. You want to know that? Go to Surah Al-Inshiqaq. It's easy. Allah said,
amma man utiya kitabahu biyaminihi fasawfa yuhasabu hisaban yasira wa yanqalibu ila ahlihi masrura.
Whoever receives his book with the right hand, his judgment will be facilitated. It will be easy. Allah will not give him thorough judgment. The judgment will be lightened. May Allah put us among. Don't ever forget this dua in your prayer. Before you say salam in your tahiyyah, say, Allahumma hasibni hisaban yasira. Please, let's repeat it. Allahumma. We are not ready to repeat. Allahumma hasibni hisaban yasira. Amen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us easy hisab. Then Allah say, whoever receives his book with the right hand, his hisab will be very lightened.
وَيَنْقَلِبُ إِلَىٰ أَهْلِهِ مَسْرُورًا.
He will return to his family happy, happily. He will be telling people,
هَا أُمُقْرَأُ كِتَابِيَا.
This is my book. Read it. This is my record. Read it. What of the other one? Do we need to know? I think it's necessary to know. It's important to know what will happen to him or her.
وَأَمَّا مَنْ أُوْتِيَ كِتَابَهُ وَرَاءَ ظَهْرِهِ فَسَوْفَ يَدْعُو ثُبُورًا فَسَوْفَ يَدْعُو ثُبُورًا وَيَصْلَى سَعِيرًا. إِنَّهُ كَانَ فِي أَهْلِهِ مَسْرُورًا إِنَّهُ ظَنَّ أَنْ لَنْ يَحُورَ بَلَى بَلَى إِنَّ رَبَّهُ كَانَ بِهِ بَصِيرًا.
As for he who receives his book behind his back, do you know what he will say? He will cry out for destruction.
فَسَوْفَ يَدْعُو ثُبُورًا.
He will pray to Allah to destroy him. In another surah, Allah said,
لَا تَدْعُو يَوْمَ ثُبُورًا وَاحِدًا وَدْعُوا ثُبُورًا كَثِيرًا.
Don't call out or cry out for one destruction. No, cry out for destructions. Many.
يَوْمَ يَنْظُرُ الْمَرْءُ مَا قَدَّمَتْ يَدَاهُ وَيَقُولُ الْكَافِرُ يَا لَيْتَنِي Ya laytani kuntu turaba.
The day that your deed will be brought before you, you see your deeds. A kafir, the one that is ungrateful to Allah, will say, oh Allah, I wish you turn me into a dust. May Allah make it easy for us. Now, everyone has received his book. We are all set for judgment. Hisab will begin. Then Allah will come.
وَجَاءَ رَبُّكَ وَالْمَلَكُ صَفًّا صَفًّا.
Your Lord will come to the venue of that Qiyamah. Allah will be the last to come, to arrive at the venue. Not only him alone, Allah will come with the angels in rows.
وَجِيءَ يَوْمَئِذٍ بِجَهَنَّمْ.
Jahannam will be brought. Jahannam will be very, very furious that day. It will be a rage. Jahannam will be brought if the hisab is about to begin. On that day, Jahannam will have 70,000 chains. And on each chain, 70,000 angels are holding it, so that Jahannam will not finish the entire creations of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It will be brought.
إِذَا رَأَتْهُمْ مِنْ مَكَانٍ بَعِيدٍ سَمِعُوا لَهَا تَغَيُّظًا وَزَفِيرًا.
As soon as Jahannam sees people from a very far distance, Jahannam will be enraged. It will start shouting, crying. Jahannam wants to finish those that disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. At that point, it will scream and all the creatures of Allah will be on their knees, including the prophets and messengers of Allah. Everyone will be saying, Allahumma nafsi, Allahumma nafsi, Allahumma nafsi. Oh Allah, I only know myself. I can only vouch for myself. I cannot stand for anyone because of that screen of Jahannam. If you like, go to Surah Al-Mulk. Allah say,
Takadu tamayyazu minal ghayz.
Jahannam almost bursts out of anger, in rage. We all fall down on our knees, saying, Allahumma nafsi, Allahumma nafsi. Jahannam will almost, overpower the angels. If not the mercy of Allah, it would have destroyed all at that event of Qiyamah. Then, before the hisab begins, Allah will call on Prophet Adam. Say, Ya Adam, O you Adam, akhrij ba'th an-nar. Remove the portion of Jahannam. Take the portion of Jahannam. Take out the portion of Jahannam from people. Then Adam will ask Allah, what is the portion of Jahannam? What portion are we giving Jahannam? Allah will say, divide people into 1,000. In each 1,000, remove 999 people there for Jahannam. La ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Hi. Inna lillahi wa inna ilahi raji'un. What do you think if you are in that group of Sayyidina Abu Bakr? Do you think you are the one? What if you fall among the group of Umar? What of Abu Huraira and the rest? I know this is scaring, right? But let's relax. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, there is Ya'juj wa Ma'juj. Out of that 1,000, they are 999. Alhamdulillah. At least there is a bit, relief. Then hisab will begin. After those people are thrown in, then hisab will begin. The hisab, Allah is sari'ul hisab, very, very swift in hisab. But remember, the mercy of Allah overpowers his anger. A servant will come with 99 records of sins. The scale will be brought. the scale is the most, is the biggest out of the creations of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's the biggest. Because it can contain the seven heavens and the earth. If the scale is brought, the angels will look at the size and they will be scared. They will say, "Ya Allah, to who you are going to use this for?" Allah say, "To whomever I will of my servant." Oh, how I wish Allah will not measure our deeds. It's better for you and me. May Allah do that for us. But it's not easy. The Prophet said, in this Ummah, 70,000 people will not receive azab, no hisab. And that 70,000, in each thousand, 70,000. It means 70,000 times. And 300 fools of Allah. So Allah knows the people that will not get that hisab and azab. May Allah make all of us among. Then hisab will begin. وَنَضَعُ الْمَوَازِينَ الْقِسْطِ لِيَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ فَلَا تُظْلَمُ نَفْسٌ شَيْئًا. A servant will come with 99 records of evil deeds. Each record is very wide and big. The records will be put on the scale, and then it's going to be very heavy on the scale. Allah will ask the servant, "Are all these sins for you?" He will admit. He say, "Yes, Allah." "Do you think my angels who are responsible for writing the deeds wrong you in any way?" You say, "No, Allah." "Do you have any excuse for committing these sins?" You say, "No, Allah." Then Allah will ask, "Do you have any good deed that you can show us or give us that will be measured against this?" You say, "Allah, I don't have anything." Allah will say, "No, of course, you have something with us." Allah will instruct the angels to bring a card. In that card, a word or a statement is written. Do you know the statement? La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. If the card is, you know, brought, the servant will say, "Oh Allah, subhanallah, what will this card do to this?" Allah will say, "Don't worry. It will be placed on the scale and it will weigh the sins, and Allah will say, go to Jannah." Allahu Akbar. How I wish I'm that person. At least I know I'm safe from Jahannam. You want to be that? But it's just one person. Allahu Akbar. May Allah make it easy for us. We've not talked about Sirat. We've not talked about Qantara. We've not talked about how to enter Jannah and Nar. And he is telling me that it's time, and I think I have to respect the time. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for us. Whatever we say that is good, may Allah accept it from us. Our shortcomings, may Allah forgive our shortcomings. Subhanaka Allahumma bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta. Astaghfiruka wa atubu. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.